Greetings everyone. For today's lunch, I'm going to be cooking a Spanish seafood fideuà. So let's begin. Well, to start off, as I'm using natural strands of saffron, I'm going to boil some water in here and chuck them in. Okay, so I've got my water there, which I just boiled in the microwave, and it went everywhere. And now, let's open this up. This is really fidgety. The last time I opened this up, the strands went everywhere. I spent half an hour picking them up. And I'm just going to use them all. I'll give them a mix. And we'll leave them here to the side. Look how yellowy that is going already. Beautiful. Okay, so the next thing is, I've got some 3 cloves of garlic here, a small onion, and some bits of pepper. I haven't got a red one, but it doesn't matter. I'm just using these bits that I have left over in the fridge. So, let's start chopping up. I'm going to chop the garlic up finely, or as finely as I can. I just finished sharpening my knife. Let's see how long it lasts. Whoa, that's sharp. Bloody hell. So, let's chop this garlic up. That'll do. And now I'm going to do the onion up as well. Right, what I do, I don't know if anyone has heard this before, so that it doesn't stink my eyes, I whistle while I chop. They say that whistling stops your eyes watering. Anyone heard of that before? Let me know. So I'll put this all together here. So I'm going to be frying it all gently, all together. The peppers included. Right, so the onion is also done. Next we'll do the peppers. This dish is very similar to one that I did not too long ago, but instead of using seafood, I used clams. You can find it in the playlist on the seafood recipes, pasta recipes, and one pan, one pot meals, if you want to give it a go. This board has taken a beating, isn't it? I like the noise that it makes on it for chopping. That's the only problem. Well, to be honest, I didn't sharpen my knife too well. I'm waiting on a new sharpening stone that I ordered, and it should arrive around, I think, next week or something, because the one that I've been using, well, it's getting a bit old. Well, at last, everything is chopped up. So we'll move on to the next step. Look. But first, let's give this a clean. That's the beauty of these boards. Doesn't leave any stains on them. And every now and then you just spray it with some, got some food safe spray. Alright then, let's move on. Okay, so the next step will be to turn this on. We're going to turn it on to number 7. And I'm going to add some aceite de oliva, which is olive oil, about 3 tablespoons. And we'll wait for that to heat up. Right, so the oil seems hot enough. If it isn't, it doesn't matter. So I'll add all this in. The garlic, onion, and the peppers, and I'm just going to gently soften everything up. And just to let you know, I'm using frozen seafood. It's a bag of about 700 grams, and I think it cost me just under €5. If I was to buy this all fresh, it'd probably cost me 50. So, no way. Well, this looks nice and soft. I'll just leave it on here for 5 more minutes. But this time I'll cover it up so the steam softens it up. Maybe I should have done that to start with. Well, too late now, isn't it? Well, this looks good. So now it's a bit of a moan time. Well, as some of you may know that have been following me from the beginning, I've been here in my tiny home, which I built with these hands, for 1 year now. Well, nearly 1 year living, but 1 year since I got my electric installed. And obviously nowadays their meters are intelligent, so on the mobile phone you get to know what you're using every day. Well, not every day, it's about 3 days behind,
So they're not very intelligent, are they?
Well, I had a look. I've got a fixed electric fee of what I use, you know, the kilowatts per hour. And mine is 19 cents when I did it a year ago. I had a look yesterday, and it's gone up to 20 cents a kilowatt hour. And they didn't even bother notifying me, which really pissed me off. So I went to their website and had a look. And if you want to sign up with them, they're doing it for 15 cents a kilowatt hour. So how do you explain that? Well, thieving. So I think it's change time, isn't it? Okay, so back to business. What I'm going to do next is add about 3 tablespoons of tomato, fried tomato, and I'm going to add my favourite spice, 1 teaspoon of paprika, sweet paprika, what else? Right, I'm going to add a bit of fish and seafood broth. It also has onion and carrot. This is nice and cheap one. €1 for a litre, and it's a branded one. I really hate these the lids they do these nowadays. They do it with the milk also. So annoying. So I'll just add a bit there. About half a cup, half a glass. Just so that we can dissolve this. And yes, it is smelling good. I'll leave it there for about 5 minutes. Okay, so this is looking good. So the next thing I'll do, I'm going to chuck in the noodles. If you haven't got these type of noodles, just have a read in the description and I'll tell you what you can use. And also, I'm going to add the, look at that lovely colour, beautiful, isn't it? I'll add the saffron. I'm not going to leave any strands out, because being the world's most expensive herb, well, you just can't do that, can you? I'll add some broth in a minute to that. So let's give this a mix. And I just like to leave it there for about a minute before adding the fish and seafood broth or stock. Same thing, isn't it? I don't know. Right, that's enough. And by the way, I'm cooking on number 7, medium high, as I usually do. Just to let you know. So now I'm going to add the broth. God, I hate this bloody lid. There you go, that's better, isn't it? You know what? Usually I save a quarter of this to make a soup in the evening, but today, just going to chuck it all in. Oops, I forgot to... No. That's it. We'll give this a mix about. And what I'm going to do is wag the heat up until it comes to a boil, and then I'll turn it down. Okay, that was quick. That's boiling nicely. So what I'll do before anything else, I'm just going to have a quick salt check. It shouldn't need any because the broth that I use has plenty of salt. Exactly, no salt needed. But that is according to whatever broth that you use. So I'm going to turn it down now to number 7. And I'm just going to leave it there boiling for 15-20 minutes. I'll let you know in the end. Okay then, so 10 minutes have gone by. It was quicker than I expected. So the next step is to add the seafood in. So as this is frozen, it'll give the noodles a shock and completely slow down. Oops, I forgot these. I love how these turn red within seconds. So, we'll leave them there. Still on number 7. And this time I'm going to cover it up completely. I'll leave it there for 5 minutes, I reckon. I'll tell you later. Okay, so it's been exactly 10 minutes, and this is done. Look at that. Yummy, yummy, yummy. So now what I'm going to do is turn the stove off. Turn the extractor fan off. And I'll wait for that to cool down for 5 minutes. I'll put it to one side. And then I'm going to push it up with some red peppers. Roasted red peppers in brine, I think they are. With garlic. And a bit of parsley. Because today I'm not going to serve it in a dish. We'll just serve this on the table. And that's it. So I'll be back in a second. Okay, so here it is. I hope that you like it. Thank you for watching. Please leave me a comment, etc., etc., etc. And I look forward to sharing my next recipe video with you. Thank you once again, and goodbye.